Hello boys, good morning. I would like to start my class with lot of blessing for you, so that you just remain happy and safe, and you just make your you just can make you the proper use of time for your very bright future. Because you are our students, you are just like our sons, and for your betterment, we are always here to support you. Guys, we were just discussing about different types of question. That means as a review class is going on, we just had some review class on our earlier session, but finally we are now reviewing before the test exam, just focusing on the test exam so that we can answer any kind of question and can get very good marks on our test exams, so that we can allow for the board exam. Chapter 3 was our discussion, last discussion was on chapter 3 motion, we were just trying to discuss some important topics from this chapter. Sorry guys, though we were just discussing from chapter 3-4, sometimes from motion chapter 2, or in case of sometimes in case of chapter 3, diagram or graph based question are given priority in exam, and most of the time we just try to fail the graph and understand the try to understand the we just fail to understand the graph, and we just avoid this kind of question in our exam. But if we can understand the graph, the math or the calculation will be very easier to us. So whether the graph based question come in from chapter 2 or chapter 3, if we just have some enough practice, we can answer all kind of question. Such a kind of question is given in the STEM here. The STEM is the graph based. The nature of applied force on a car has been shown in two graphs. If we just observe the graph over here, first graph, that means in figure P, this represent the this change of displacement with time for a curve, and time is given in the units of second and displacement in unit of meter, and some values are over here. And in another graph, that means in graph Q, in figure Q, this is another graph where the displacement and time, variation of displacement and time are given, but the graph representation is different than P. What is the question? First one is, what is simple harmonic motion? Second one is, why is walking hard on a muddy road? Third one is, calculate the distance traveled by a car of figure P, and finally analyze the velocity of a different situation of a car from graph Q. What is the answer of question A? That is a familiar question to you. You have learned about different kinds of motion, and simple harmonic motion is one of them. Simple harmonic motion is such a kind of periodic motion where the object just travels for its first half time, that means the first half time in a specific direction, and then it moves to the opposite direction, and just travels for next portion of time. So that kind of motion is called simple harmonic motion. And second question, I haven't I'm just telling it by orally. I haven't written the terms here, that means the question A and B, because these are very familiar questions to you. Question number B, why is walking hard on a muddy road? From Newton's third law of motion, we know that every action has its equal and opposite reaction. So whenever we are applying a very good amount of force on an object, that will have a reaction. And while walking, if we just walk on a smooth road, then we just can walk in a smooth way, because we are applying force, just enough amount of force, and due to the back of that force or due to the reaction of that force, we just can walk on our road or walk on our way. But if the road is muddy, or if there is sand on roads, and then it is difficult to walk on that road, because we can't apply so much force on that road, on a muddy road. That's why in reaction, the reaction force is also very poor, and we just fail to feel free on walking road. Another cause is here the frictional force. While we are walking on a smooth road, the frictional force acting there, the frictional force that acts on a muddy road is very low. That means frictional force is not enough for a smooth walking. That's why we just feel it hard to walk on a muddy road, and we can't walk on a slippery or muddy road. Two logics are here. First one is the Newton's third law. The applying force is poor, so the reaction force is also poor. That's why we can move freely on a muddy road. And second one is the frictional force is less than walking on a normal road. That's why it is hard to walk on muddy road. Question number C, calculate the distance traveled by a car of figure P. If we just examine the figure P here, we have to determine the total distance. In the graph, the displacement and the time is given. And what will be the total distance according to the equation of laws of motion? We know that S is equals ut plus half a t square, where S depicts the distance. Denotes the distance, and u initial velocity, t time, a acceleration. And as from the diagram, we can see that with the change of time, with the raise of time, the distance is just decreasing. The velocity, or if the slope of this graph, that means the slope of distance time graph, represent the velocity. The velocity will decrease here, and if the velocity decreases, the acceleration also decreases. That means deceleration happens here on that case. So here we, at first we have to determine the value of acceleration. So for calculating acceleration, we have to determine the knowledge of initial velocity and final velocity. And from the graph, we just can see that as it starts from initial point, and in this point the velocity from according to this slope, the velocity will be displacement divided by time, and that will be 15 meter per second. But in case of the final velocity, as the graph is just coming to the base, and so here in this point there is no value of distance, so finally the velocity will be zero. And then the deceleration we can calculate from here. Deceleration will be A equals V minus U by T, where V is 0 and U is 15 meter per second, and T is total time span is here 30 second. For covering the total distance, total time is 30 second, and according to this information, our deceleration is minus 0.5 meter per second square. And applying this value on the equation of motion, S equals ut plus half a t square, we will get the distance covered by the car from figure P will be 225 meter. This is question number C. And in question number D, it was the question number D, analyze the velocity of different situation of a curve from the graph Q. We have to analyze the graph Q. This is graph Q, and according to this graph, we have to make some comment on the velocity at different position. First of all, if we just follow the graph as it is starting from the point A, point O, initial point O, or origin is O, then from starting from O, it just we just can divide the graph in several points, several part. For example, O A, then A B, then B C, then C D. So first part is OA. Here the there is no change of position of the curve. The curve position is not changing here with time. So that's why we can say that in part OA, the curve is in rest position and it is remaining at rest position for 5 seconds, first 5 seconds. Then it comes the part AB. In this part, the displacement is increasing, but it is increasing uniformly with time, because it is a straight line approaching to a specific point, and so the change is here uniform. The displacement is changing uniformly with time, and for the time is 5 seconds. So here we will get a velocity, and there will be uniform velocity, and from displacement time graph, but the slope represent the velocity. Here the slope is AB, and according to this portion, the change of velocity is from 10 to 0, 0 to 10, and the change of time is 5 seconds. That means 5 to 10 seconds, which represent 5 seconds ultimately, and so the velocity will be uniform velocity, and its value will be 2 meter per second. That means for the part AB of the graph, the car is moving with a uniform velocity of 2 meter per second. For the third part of the graph is BC. In this portion, we can see that there is no change of distance. This is a straight line and there is no change in distance. So the car is in rest position, and the change of velocity, as it is in rest position, there is no change of distance or displacement. That means the change of velocity is also zero. Finally, for the part CD, if we observe the part CD over here, this is just same as AB, where the displacement is increasing uniformly with the change in time. So this is, will be also a uniform velocity. The area of under slope CD. That means by slope CD we will get the velocity here, and because displacement time slope represent the velocity, and the change of velocity is from 10 to 20 meter, change of this displacement, and change of time is 15 to 20 second. That means for 5 second time, the uniform velocity will be 2 meter per second. That means if we want to make a comment over here, for the part OA, the car remains at rest position. For the part AB, the car is moving with uniform velocity of 2 meter per second. For the part BC, the car is again remaining on rest position, no change in position. That means there is no change in velocity. Finally, for the part CD, is moving with uniform velocity of 2 meter per second. So guys, you just have to try a lot to make practice with different kinds of graph based question, because from chapter 2 and 3 graph based questions are given priority in board exam also. Try to solve every kind of question, and just make a good preparation, and in our regular class we will try to discuss all the important topics again. Boys, that's all for now. goodbye for now. Just stay happy, stay safe. Goodbye. Thank you.